Yeah, so before we get on to the first real topic, let me introduce you to my new friend, which is that snake down there. Yeah, so before we get on to the first real topic, let me introduce you to my new friend, which is that snake down there. Yes. So let's all say hello to the snake. Sergei Sorokin had a bit of a bizarre brake failure because a sandwich wrapper ended up in his brake ducts, causing him to have brake failure. I first thought it was down to his crap driving. Max Verstappen had an uncharacteristic spin at the start of the Grand Prix, which caused him to lose a few places. I was surprised that he managed to keep it. However, I was also surprised that how much input his engineer gave him over the radio about his driving, and I thought that was really uncharacteristic for Max Verstappen. So, let me know what you guys think in the comment section below, because I think he got a bit flustered at this race. Having said that, the way he caught I only have a still image of the spin. I mean, if I was allowed to include videos in from the extra race, I would, but obviously I'm not allowed to do that due to the Formula One management. I don't want to get a copyright strike. However, it was absolutely awesome how he caught it, and that just shows his skill. These hard problems caused first they caused a virtual safety car, and then that was converted into an actual safety car, and Verstappen decided to overtake Fernando Alonso, which is absolutely a no-no, for obvious reasons, because marshals were going to track, and everything, the driver has to be prepared to stop. So Verstappen did not get a reprimand or a penalty by the stewards, and I believe that this was due to the fact that he actually waved Fernando Alonso back through. But at first, Fernando was a bit skeptical of going past, as I found out while I was watching the Formula One pit pass on the official F1 YouTube channel, with Will Buxton So Will seems to be found employment again after after NBC decided to terminate their Formula One coverage at the tail end of last year. So I'm very happy about that. So welcome back, Will. So the race was won by Sebastian Vettel in front of Lewis Hamilton, and followed by Kimi Raikkonen on the final step of the podium. The reason why Sebastian Vettel managed to jump ahead of Lewis Hamilton was because Mercedes didn't react to the pit stop in during the virtual safety car during the safety car period. However, on top of that, Mercedes are now claiming that there was a glitch in their simulation and simulation and prediction software. I'm very happy for Fernando Alonso, and he got 5th position and 10 points in the championship. The reason why I'm so happy is because hopefully that is some payback for the last 3 fruitless years with Honda, because he must have gotten really frustrated. So I'm very happy for Fernando. So Carlos Sainz had some issues with his drinks bottle, and apparently he drank too much and too fast during the Grand Prix, and apparently he felt sick, which reminded me of when I did exactly the same thing and drank about 6 liters in the space of 1 hour when I had back in 2007 when I was in Stafford General Hospital with kidney stones, and a friend of mine a friend of mine told me to drink a lot, and I took it literally and drank about 6 liters in 1 hour, and it all resulted in my mate Andy being vomited on. So I know exactly what Carlos was feeling at the time. Despite that, he managed to secure the last championship point for 10th position. Behind me you can now see the positions and the qualifications. This has been my view on the 2018 Australian Grand Prix race. So thanks for watching, and do consider to support me financially if you can, for the reason which I wrote in the notes at the top of this video. here below. There are many ways how you can do this, and if you can't, just make this video go viral. And I'm out of here, and I'll see you in Bahrain. All right. Cheers for watching, guys. Bye.